He opened his eyes, and although a brave and callous man, he lay still, paralyzed with the fear which forbids motion. The dim light of a candle, recently lit, flashed upon the bodkin-like dagger held at his throat. He gazed at the thin line of gleaming steel, fascinated. Already his skin had been broken. A few drops of blood were upon the collar of his pajamas. The hand which held that deadly, assailing weapon, small, slim, very feminine, curving from somewhere behind the bed curtain, belonged to some unseen person. He tried to shrink further back upon the pillow. The hand followed him, displaying glimpses, now of a soft, white-sleeved arm. He lay quite still, the muscles of his right arm growing tenser as he prepared for a snatch at those cruel fingers. Then a voice came, a slow, feminine, and rather wonderful voice. "If you move," it said, "you will die. Remain quite still." Dominie was fully conscious now, his brain at work, calculating his chances with all the cunning of the trained hunter who seeks to avoid death. Reluctantly, he was compelled to realize that no movement of his could be quick enough to prevent the driving of that thin stiletto into his throat, if his hidden assailant should keep her word. So he lay still. "Why do you want to kill me?" he asked, a little tensely. There was no reply, yet somehow he knew that he was being watched. Ever so slightly, those curtains around which the arm had come were being parted. Through the chink, someone was looking at him. The thought came that he might call out for help, and once more his unseen enemy read his thought.